In this video, I'm going to show you how to set a maximum character length on a text form field in Microsoft Word. This is so you can set a maximum limit on the number of characters that a user can type into a form field so it won't expand and mess up the formatting on your form. If you want to see more on how to create fillable forms, be sure and subscribe to my channel. I hope you enjoyed this video. All right, here we have a behavior-based interview questionnaire, and this is a form that's been created in Microsoft Word, and right now it is restricted, so there's protection on this form. So right now a user could open this up and all they can do is fill in the form fields. But let's say we have a user who comes to type in their name in the form field here and they have a really long name. Notice how when we keep typing that the form field will shift and mess up the formatting of your form, and we don't want that to happen. So what we can do is actually set a limit on the number of characters and spaces that a user can type into that field. Let me go ahead and delete this back. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to my developer tab. So you'll want to have this enabled when you're creating and working with your Microsoft Word forms. You can check out the other video on my channel if you need to see how to enable that tab. But on your developer tab, I'm going to go ahead and click on stop protection because this is a protected form. So right now I can go over and make edits to my form. So I'm going to double click and open up the properties of this text form field. And notice that this is a legacy form field, and therefore on the properties, I have the ability to set a maximum length. And so right now it defaults to unlimited, and I can type in a number here. So let's say I want to type in 20 characters, and that's going to include spaces as well. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And now I'm going to go back up to my developer tab. When we click on restrict editing, this pops up over here. We would restrict allowing only to fill in forms, and then we can click on yes, start enforcing protection. We don't need to put a password, so we can click OK. So now that we have a character limit out here, if I type, if I keep typing, it's not going to let me type beyond that limit, and so therefore it won't automatically adjust or mess up the formatting of the form. So if you have another form field where this occurs, you might want to actually, I'm going to go ahead and protect it again. You might want to actually count how many characters. I would do a caps lock and count how many characters you can actually type before it starts adjusting the formatting, and then back up a few. And let's say on this one, we want to do about 30 as an example. You would count how many characters and spaces you want to allow, and then you can set that up. So I'm going to go ahead and backspace, we'll stop protection, double click to open the properties, and we can set a higher limit on this one, and then click OK. So now when we start our protection on the form and distribute it, users who need to type in that field, they will get to type the maximum number of characters, and anything beyond that will get truncated or cut off. Now, if you like this particular form and want to see some of the other features of how we created it, definitely check out the course on creating fillable forms in Microsoft Word. That's on my channel. I'll include a link in the description below. Now, one thing to note, I'm going to stop protection, and if you happen to use content control form fields in your form, so for example, I'll just delete here, and if you happen to use, say, the plain text form field for your content control, you may have noticed that there is no way, if you open up the properties, there is no delivered way that you can set a maximum character limit. So I recommend using the legacy tool forms. And so if we cancel out of there, you'll be able to access legacy forms on this drop down here. You'll see legacy tools, and you'll have the text form field, checkbox, a drop down list selection, and different options. And I don't recommend that to mix and match content controls and legacy fields within the same document. But if you do happen to use both, my recommendation is to definitely test your form thoroughly before you distribute it. If you found this video helpful, be sure and share it with your friends and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks for watching.